City Pulse with Gord Martineau and Roskowski and the City Pulse News Team bring you Toronto's News.
Good evening. The body of Edwin Harold Ballard has been laid to rest.
That story tonight from Laura Di Battista.
He was a renegade, rogue, outrageous, putting everybody on. That was Harold. He was marvelous with the media.
Harold Ballard's final resting place will be here at the Parklawn Cemetery, next to the body of his late wife, Dorothy. The funeral service itself was a quiet affair held at the Grace Church on the hill.
The private service in Forest Hill lasted 40 minutes, with 100 family members and close friends in attendance. Among them was Dick Beddoes.
That was a mark of his daughter, Mary Elizabeth. She wanted her dad to go out in a state of grace, I guess, as Christians say. And that's why the church service and the church location was kept pretty secret. What she didn't want was a big media scene that might have involved Yolanda Ballard, Yolanda McMillan Ballard.
The public was told the service would be held at the Turner and Porter Funeral Home at Bloor and Jane. Many fans were gathered outside this afternoon, hoping to pay their last respects to a Toronto legend.
I'd like to see the what's left of the great man going by, you know. That's if he is going by. Seems to be a lot of confusion, though.
Yeah. Do you blame the family for wanting to have this private?
No, not really.
They were saying that, what's her name going to cash in or crash in? I just want to see what she's going to do. I think she's a nut.
Talking about Yolanda?
Yes.
He did a lot for the Leafs and for the community. He was a good charity man, and I think he really did respect everyone.
Harold's will will be read in private tomorrow. There are conflicting reports on what it contains. Some say he leaves all of his $110 million fortune to his charity. Others say his children will be taken care of. The public finds out on Thursday. Gord, back to you.
Thank you, Laura.